What I wish I knew before becoming a data analyst. If you're watching this, you're probably thinking, should I change my career to a data analyst? Will it be worth it to learn data analysis skills? And what if I become a data analyst and realize that this is not the career for me? By sharing my perspective of what I wish I knew before becoming a data analyst, I hope to help answer these questions for you. Now, starting with my background, I have a college degree in business and sociology, and I worked as a litigation consultant for the first 5 years out of school. Then I was completely burnt out and decided I needed a career change. So I self-studied data analysis skills to become a data analyst in healthcare. From there, I took a boot camp to learn more data science skills and change my career into a business intelligence engineer at Amazon, which is what I do today. So I share my background because one of the things I wish I had known is that there is not just one path to becoming a data analyst. For the longest time, I had regretted not having a computer science background, the fact that I don't have a master's in data analytics. And today, a lot of my peers that I work with come from those backgrounds. And what I realize now, hindsight, having been a data analyst years later, I realize that it doesn't matter because we all ended up in the same place. So yes, I do think having a master's does help. Yes, having a computer science does help as well, but there's so many different ways you can end up in the same data analyst role. One is by self-studying. Another is a bootcamp, which I was able to leverage and change my career from healthcare to tech. So if you're asking and you have these thoughts of, can I become a data analyst without a computer science degree? Then my answer is absolutely yes. And talking about skills, I wish there was less emphasis on math and more on critical thinking. Yes, you do need to know math and when to use the right formulas, but what's more important is that you know when to use them, as well as how to solve a problem using math. So I remember when I was first learning how to do data analysis and learning statistics and all these math calculations, I really thought it was over my head and thought maybe this is not the job for me because math is not my strong suit. But come to realize all the code does the calculations for you. And with AI too, it does all the calculations for you. So you really just need to know when to use it and be able to read the data. You want to know the difference between when to use a median versus an average versus how to calculate it. And that is going to be the trend with automation. And so if you feel like math isn't your strong suit, don't feel like that's something that should stop you from a data analyst career path. When thinking about a career change, you have to consider salary. When I was growing up, I always thought that the doctors and lawyers were the ones who were making good money, and that was the only way. So I took the law school exam thinking I'd be a lawyer. Turns out that was not for me. And when I decided to take my leap into data analytics, I actually took a pay cut. And I really thought that forever this was going to be how much I was going to make for the rest of my life. But little did I know, and I wish I had known, that this is a career path where if you put in the work of learning the new skills, there's a way to make more money as your career progresses. So I want to give you some realistic numbers of what you can expect as you're looking into the data analytics role. And salary does really matter based on location, experience, and industry, but this is what you can expect. For an entry-level data analyst role, you can look at around $76,000. And then as you become more senior and become manager of data analytics, the salary moves up to around $107,000. And maybe you decide that you want to become a data scientist or data engineer, and that goes to around $123,000. And you do not have to become a data analyst first if you want to move into data science and data engineer, but the skill sets do really overlap. And if you decide to get into tech, the salary goes over $200,000. So my point here is that there's a lot of opportunity to increase your pay in the data career path, and don't feel like this is a dead-end role because there's so much more you can do once you start learning more skills. And talking about skills, the skills that will really get you to increase your pay is people skills. When I was first learning data analysis, the focus is on the hard skills, right? You have to learn Excel, SQL, a BI visualization tool, which is definitely all skills that you should know. But I realized about 5 years after working as a data analyst that slowly the people who had really strong people skills, the people that were building relationships, really good at communicating, had so many more opportunities and were getting better jobs than the ones who might have been more technically savvy. So I think this is a lesson learned for all careers, really, that you want to be able to have really strong people skills, because that is really what will open up opportunities for you. The next is managing stakeholders. So in my previous video, when I talk about what I do as a data analyst, which I will link up here, I talk about the unrealistic expectations that you'll get from stakeholders. They're going to ask you ad hoc work, make you stay late at night. And when I was young, a young data analyst, I thought that this was okay, that this was just the nature of the work. I would say yes to all the requests and work the late hours. But as I've grown and now that I'm more experienced, I've come to realize that you have to manage your stakeholders and that there are systems in place to do that. So what we do now is we have a sprint process. So anybody who has requests from you will put it in a queue and you prioritize those tasks and work on it during a sprint and only commit to what you can work on during those 2 weeks. So anybody who has new requests for you or fire drill requests, those get prioritized in a queue so that you don't end up having to drop everything you're working on just to work on those things for them. And this system and process has really helped me manage my stakeholders, and it's something I wish I had known earlier in my career. Transferable skills. As the years pass as a data analyst, I find myself thinking, do I still want to be a data analyst? Did I waste all my years just learning these skills? And I get asked a lot too, what if I go to grad school and realize that I don't want to be a data analyst? Would I have wasted my time? And looking back, I would say no. Maybe I'm biased, but the skills you learn as a data analyst, your communication skills, your ability to analyze data and have strong problem-solving skills are extremely transferable and are not a waste at all. There's other tech roles you can even transfer them to, such as a product manager or project manager, which are also considered tech roles and pay pretty well. So a product manager is someone who manages the life cycle of a product. They're the ones who are going to manage the different teams and be able to pull their own analytics to see whether their product is successful. You also have project managers who are managing projects, and they will be able to pull their own data to be able to make business decisions. So you'll see that there's a lot of transferable skills, and in my career, I've actually seen a lot of people transfer between these two roles of being a data analyst and then maybe they're a product manager. So I don't believe that the skills you learn is a waste, and solely just by investing in your skills, you're already setting yourself up for success. Now, if you like this video, please like and subscribe, as it really does support the channel. And I will link my other video where I talk about the harsh reality of being a data analyst, just so that you can get a realistic picture of what it's like. Thank you so much, and I will see you there.